Well, the smart money's on Harlow, and the moon is in the street. The shadow boys are breaking all the laws. Well, the smart money's on Harlow, and the moon is in the street. The shadow boys are breaking all the laws. And you reach of East St. Louis, and the wind is making speeches.
Hello and welcome to Pursuit a Perfect System. I hope you are all well and staying safe. In this video, I am concluding the review for the JCAT OPTIMO 3 Duo Linear Power Supply, and there'll also be an A-B comparison sound demo in the video as well, so get your headphones ready for that bit. Before I get into the review, I hope you've all seen the introduction video, really, or the history video, where I go through my history of linear power supplies and to some degree battery power supplies, because I think the position we are in today compared to maybe 8 or so years ago, the market's a completely different place. And I feel like I've got, you know, a huge amount of history and experience of different types of linear power supplies and even some battery power supplies to form, you know, a very informed opinion about the JCAT OPTIMO 3 Duo Linear Power Supply. And what is it? Well, it is a dual output, no compromise linear power supply. This particular version that I've been reviewing has dual 5-volt outputs, and each of those outputs are capable of producing 3 amps worth of current, which is a lot for a linear power supply. And you can have the OPTIMO 3 customized to output different voltages if that better suits your equipment. And as I mentioned, the OPTIMO 3 Duo is designed to be a no compromise linear power supply, and really it's designed to be the perfect power source for JCAT's very important dedicated cards for computers or computer audio. They are USB cards and their network cards. It's a linear power supply, so its uses and then its benefits go way outside of computer audio, which is the bit that I think is really very cool. Now, the OPTIMO 3 Duo is a premium priced unit. What do I mean by that? Well, it costs 1,500 euros, which initially seems like a lot of money for this type of product, but there's actually a hell of a lot here to justify the premium status and then the premium price tag. The OPTIMO 3 Duo comes in very nice packaging. It travels safely and securely in some very thick protective packaging. Secondly is the build of the OPTIMO Duo 3. Now, things have gotten better, but more often than not, it always appears like linear power supply designers and manufacturers, they find a case and then they make the linear power supply fit the case, which is totally fine, but normally means linear power supply designs are pretty bland and pretty boring and pretty rudimentary. JCAT's OPTIMO 3 Duo linear power supply is unlikely to win any beauty contests, but look at it, it looks completely bespoke. It has a nice thick front faceplate, some very nice styling on the ventilation fins, and the overall build quality is excellent. Two very nice touches and attentions to detail. Firstly, the Furatech IEC power inlet socket, nice. And secondly are the metal lock-in output connectors, which accept a Nutric connector, but they are not made by Nutric. They are made by a company that I'm not aware of, I didn't recognize the name, but the actual build quality and the feel of the lock-in mechanism feels really high quality and feels built to last a lifetime. Fantastic. The two cables that come with the JCAT OPTIMO 3 Duo are fantastic. I really, really love the cables. The build quality of them is brilliant, and I really love their specification, the fact that they're made from PCOCC copper. The Nutric connectors that are used are the metal versions. Yes, very nice. And the DC connectors that are used at the other end, they are the best DC connectors that I've ever seen. They fit really snug and secure when you plug them in. And then I think something that's very important to stress with the OPTIMO 3 Duo power supply is that it's been completely designed from scratch by JCAT. Previously, JCAT have offered other power supplies, such as the JCAT 200 watt Mark 1 linear power supply that I'll be doing the AB comparison with shortly in the video. That was licensed by JCAT, but it was manufactured and designed by a different company. But I think it's great to see JCAT develop as a business by developing their own products, such as the USB cards, the network cards, and now the Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply. And internally, it has some very nice features, such as a resin potted transformer, Nishikon fine gold capacitors, LT3045 linear regulators, and more. All very good. But what does the Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply sound like? Well, I think the best way to talk about how it sounds is in a direct comparison with a linear power supply that I've used in my review system for years, and you would have seen it feature in lots of different videos. That's JCAT's first linear power supply, the 200 watt Mark 1. And I still really like the 200 watt Mark 1 linear power supply. I don't like it as much now as I used to, but I still like it. And that is because when you use it, compared to maybe other linear power supplies, and definitely compared to switching type of power supplies, music seems to have more life, it seems to have more verve, and it seems to have more spirit. They're all the things that I really like about that linear power supply. But what's, I suppose, interesting, and what I've learned about that power supply, is that for all the benefits that it brings to the music, at the same time, it's adding its own sound to the music. And some of that sound that's being added is what I'm perceiving as those benefits, more life and more verve. To explain that better, really, it's adding distortion to music. And sometimes distortion added to certain types of music can be perceived as a benefit. I think with bass, sometimes noise and distortion in bass can make bass seem more full, and it can make it seem more rounded. And I think with vocals, it can sometimes make them seem more expressive. But the downside of the 200 watt Mark 1 power supply adding noise to the system is that it's adding it to all the sound. And that adds, I think, attention to the music. It kind of adds like a grayness as well, a grain, and it kind of sits itself on top of the music. You'll hear this in the demo in a minute. And other times when there's big peaks, or I think what's called crescendos in music, when you listen using the Mark 1 200 watt, the music seems to hit a brick wall and stop and kind of compress, like what you would expect an engineer in the mixing or mastering studio to add compression, you know, boost the volume, add compression, which is what I thought it was. But now I've heard better linear power supplies, I know it's actually not the engineer, it's the linear power supply which is causing that effect. Comparing this to the Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply, which has a very obvious cleaner output. In fact, I would go as so far to say it has a battery-like cleanliness to its output. Using the Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply, the sound is so much cleaner, which makes it crisper. It gives a better perceived dynamic range, a better overall sound stage, literally improved clarity from top to bottom, bass right up to treble. For me, the JCAT Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply has allowed my review system to take several significant steps forward in terms of quality of sound, in terms of clarity of sound. And yeah, I did really like the 200 watt Mark 1, really like that linear power supply, but it's been very, very much superseded by the Optimo 3 Duo. And that's something else really important here, which again, you'll hear in this AB demo, which I'm about to run for you. But before we get into that, I just want to explain that in the AB demo and how I've used these linear power supplies to compare to each other, it's not been a fair test. The Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply has been powering two things within my audio PC or my computer digital transport, where the 200 watt Mark 1 linear power supply was only powering one thing. I was using a different linear power supply to power the second thing. So that means that this test is skewed very much in favor of the 200 watt Mark 1 linear power supply. But as you'll hear, really doesn't matter, because the Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply, each individual output is galvanically isolated from each other, which means it's as close to having two separate linear power supplies as you can get from a single box. And I think that's another one of the huge benefits of it, one of the things that really appeals to me. But enough talk, let me roll an A-B demo so you can hear all of this for yourself.
Well, the smart money's on Harlow, and the moon is in the street. The shadow boys are breaking all the laws. And you reach of East St. Louis, and the wind is making speeches. And the rain sounds like a round of applause. Well, the smart money's on Harlow, and the moon is in the street. The shadow boys are breaking all the laws. And you reach of East St. Louis, and the wind is making speeches. And the rain sounds like a round of applause. And the things you can't remember, tell the things you can't forget, that history puts a stain in every dream. Well, she said she'd stick around until the bandages came off. But these mama's boys just don't know when to quit. And the things you can't remember, tell the things you can't forget, that history puts a stain in every dream. Well, she said she'd stick around until the bandages came off. But these mama's boys just don't know when to quit.
I hope you enjoyed that demo. Now, I appreciate it's really difficult to assess a system's overall sound quality from just short clips of music, but I think it's very easy to hear and assess the sound quality differences between the two linear power supplies. As you can very, very clearly hear, even via a recording, the extra clarity, detail, and resolution that's brought to the sound of my hi-fi system from the Optimo 3 Duo linear power supply compared to the 200 watt Mark 1. It's a serious and significant improvement in pretty much every clarity area. So I'm going to conclude the review for the JCAT OPTIMO 3 Duo Linear Power Supply with just a little chat about the perceived value of it. Now at €1,500, as I mentioned, it initially seems like a lot of money for this type of product, but I think we have to factor in the two really very high quality cables that come with the OPTIMO 3 Duo. And I think if they was being sold separately, I'm sure they would be or would charge or cost maybe €500 for those. So it's about €1,000 for the OPTIMO 3 Duo, actual power supply on its own. And it's impossible for me to, you know, deem whether you think it's value or not. But what I will say is, what is a linear power supply or any power supply supposed to do? It's pretty simple, isn't it, really? It's supposed to provide the exact power or current to the product or component or hi-fi product that it's powering with the lowest noise possible. And traditionally, or I suppose the thinking is that a battery in isolation is the lowest noise power source possible. So if a linear power supply has a battery-like power output, or the benefits of a battery, while having the benefits of a linear power supply as well, then that's pretty cool, right? Pretty damn cool. I want to thank JCAT for sending me the OPTIMO 3 Duo linear power supply for this review, and I apologize that you will not be getting it back. So I hope you've enjoyed this review. I hope it's been useful and helpful, and I'll definitely be seeing you soon. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye.